Today I want to show y'all how to make this hanging 3-gallon tomato plant. We got this galvanized bucket at our local Home Depot, or even Lowe's has these. I finished it off with some herbs, some basil and mint. So you can choose to do that or not, but it's a very simple, easy little home project. And we put it on a shepherd's hook, but make sure that it's sturdy because it ends up being pretty heavy. I have flipped my galvanized bucket over. And again, we have our drill and our 3¼-inch bit. I have my feet tight around the galvanized bucket. And I'm gonna get it going, and then as it starts to spin, I'm gonna press it down and give it a little bit of pressure. I have this part up against my leg because it's gonna wanna twist. I have just cut the hole, and one thing that you need to keep in mind is that it's going to be very, very sharp. So as you're working with this cocoa liner and you're placing your plant in there, you're gonna want to be very mindful of the sharp edges. What the cocoa liner is going to do is it's going to keep the plant from falling through this hole in the bottom of the galvanized bucket. I bought a roll of cocoa liner at the local nursery. They have it in rolls and you can just buy certain sizes. To measure the size, I simply just set the bottom on top of the cocoa liner and I just cut around it. It doesn't have to be exactly, because it can kind of fold up around the sides on the inside. All right, so now I've cut around. What I'm gonna do is place it in the bucket. This is where my soil is gonna go on top. But we need to find the center hole, so I'm gonna flip it over. Find the center, flip it, and just make a little cut. There's the center right there. So I'm going to fold it in half. Do a cut this way. A small, maybe 1 to 2 inch cut, and I'm going to go this way like a plus sign. And this is where we're going to fish the tomato plant through that small opening right there. And then I'm going to take my tomato plant and gently fish it through. Careful not to damage the plant. Okay, so this is where I'm gonna need my glove. I've already fished it through the cocoa liner, and then I'm gonna push it through from the back and gently bring it through this hole.
So this is what your bucket looks like from the top side. I put a little bit of potting soil in there. Here's the cocoa liner. And I'm just gonna continue filling that up with some potting soil.
I pulled out this wagon because when we start adding the potting soil, the bucket starts getting pretty heavy and it's hard to hold. So what I do is I put it on the side of the wagon. I have my potting soil handy. And I just dump it in. And now it's time to start planting the herbs on the top. It's handy to have a shepherd's hook or something that you can hang it on. So after you're done putting your potting soil in, you can put your plants up here and just start adding to it. You're gonna wanna water about every day or every other day. And with something like this, you're gonna wanna feed it. So there are soil tests out there to see if it's lacking any kind of nutrients, But the main thing is make sure it keeps you keep it watered. Here it is finished. I have planted my herbs up top and the tomato plant at the bottom. I would suggest using a very sturdy shepherd's hook or creating something that's even custom, because this one is put under a little bit of pressure and it's causing it to bend just a little bit. So my suggestion is to probably go with something a little bit more sturdy.